गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू चिल्ड्रन? ओके, ऑल आर फाइन, आई एम आल्सो फाइन. हैड योर ब्रेकफास्ट? आर यू रेडी फॉर टुडेज क्लास? टुडे वी विल डिस्कस वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग चैप्टर, दैट इज डेटा हैंडलिंग. इन दिस लेसन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट डेटा and how to organize the data. Now let us discuss about data. Data is nothing but some information which is in the form of words or number. Data is nothing but some information which is in the form of words or numbers. Now let us understand with better understand with some examples. In our daily life we come across several situations like buy a mobile phone, laptop or camera. For example, we want to buy a mobile phone. So what do we do? We want to first we will inquire various brands of mobile phones available in the market within our budget. Then we will see their technical feature, that is facilities they have, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, camera, triple SIM, double SIM, all the features. Then we collect the information and organize the information to take a right decision. Then we identify which brand of mobile is best. So for all these, we need to collect the information and organize the information in a proper way. So we call it as organization of information is called handling the data. So we call it as data handling. How data handling helps us? It helps us to take right decision in our day-to-day situation. Now representation of data. Data collected to organize to represent using pictographs and bar graphs. Already yesterday class we learnt about pictographs. Now discuss about bar graphs. Generally, bar graphs are used to represent independent observation with frequency. In this bar graph used to data represent visually by using bars. In this bar graphs, two types are there. One is the vertical bar graph, another one is the horizontal bar graph. Now let us discuss about vertical bar graph. Now how to construct the bar graph? Let us take an example question. Akash collect the data about the professions of people living in our colony. In this table, professions are farmers, businessmen, private employees, government employees. These are independent observation. In this, number of persons is frequency. Now, how to construct the bar graph? How many steps are there? Mainly 5 steps are there. Let us follow to draw the vertical bar graph. Then, first step is draw 2 perpendicular lines. One is horizontal x-axis, another one is y-axis. Draw the horizontal line x-axis. Next, draw the vertical line y-axis. These two are the perpendicular lines. Next step is, along the y-axis, number of peoples and along the x-axis, professions. Mark the professions. Along the x-axis mark the professions and along the y-axis mark the number of peoples. Next, start one is select the suitable scale and y-axis is 1 cm equal to 5 persons. Now why to choose the scale? In this table, larger value not represented in this bar graph sheet. Then choose the scale easily to draw the bars. Now calculate the heights of the bars, dividing the frequency with the scale. Then farmers' frequency is 10. Scale is 5. 10 divided by 5. 5 to the 10. Next one, businessman. Businessman's frequency is 15. Scale is 5. 5 3 is a 50. Next one is private employees. Private employees frequency is 20. Scale is 5. 5 4 is a 20. Next, government employees. Frequency is 30. Scale is 5. 5 6 is a 30. Then find the heights of the boss. Draw the rectangular vertical boss of same width on x-axis and with the heights are calculated above. Now draw the bars. First one is farmers. Farmers bar height is 2 cm. Then draw the vertical bar. Next one, businessman's height of the bar is 3. Then draw it. Next one is private employees. Private employees height of the bar is 4 cm. Next one, government employees. Height is 6 cm. Then draw it. This is the bar graph. In this bar graphs, use it to easily identify the data and easily answer the some type of questions. That is, which type of profession have maximum number of people? That is government employees. Next one, which type of profession having minimum number of people? Farmers. When we presenting the budget in the parliament assembly, we can see the pictographs are bar graphs. So for various sectors, how much amount they are spending. In this bar graphs are used many sectors. I hope you understand the children. Do the exercise problems. Thank you.